हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू कंप्लीट द चैप्टर द समर ऑफ द ब्यूटीफुल वाइट हॉर्स. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट. माय कजन मुराद रेस द हॉर्स अक्रॉस अ फील्ड ऑफ ड्राई ग्रासेस टू एन इरिगेशन डिच, क्रॉस द डिच ऑन द हॉर्स एंड 5 मिनट्स लेटर रिटर्न आई ड्रिपिंग वेट. The sun was coming up. Now it's my turn to ride, I said. My cousin Murad get off the horse. Ride, he said. I leapt to the back of the horse and for a moment knew the most awful fear imaginable. The horse did not move. Kick into his muscle, my cousin Murad said. What are you waiting for? We have got to take him back before everybody in the world is up and about. I kicked into the muscle of the horse. Once again it reared and snorted. Then it began to run. I didn't know what to do. Instead of running across the field to the irrigation ditch, the horse ran down the road to the vineyard of Digran Helavian, where it began to leap over vines. The horse leaped over 7 vines before I fell. Then it continued running. My cousin Murad came running down the road. I am not worried about you, he shouted. We have got to get that horse. You go this way and I will go this way. If you come upon him, be kindly. I will be near. I continued down the road and my cousin Murad went across the field toward the irrigation ditch. It took him 30 minutes to find the horse and bring him back. All right, he said, jump on. The whole world is awake now. What will we do? I said. Well, he said, we will either take him back or hide him until tomorrow morning. He didn't sound worried and I knew he would hide him and not take him back, not for a while at any rate. Where will we hide him? I said. I know a place, he said. How long did you steal this horse? I said. It suddenly dawned on me that he had been taking these early morning rides for some time and had to come for me this morning only because he knew how much I longed to ride. Who said anything about stealing a horse? He said. Anyhow, I said, how long ago did you begin riding every morning? Not until this morning, he said. Are you telling the truth? I said. Of course not, he said. But if we found out, that's what you are to say. I don't want to both of us to be liars. All you know is that we started riding this morning. All right, I said. He walked the horse quietly to the barn of a deserted vineyard which at one time had been the pride of a farmer named Fethvizian. There was some oats and dry alfalfa in the barn. We began walking home. It wasn't easy, he said, to get the horse to behave so nicely. At first it wanted to run wild. But as I told you, I have a way with a horse. I get it to what to do anything I want it to do. Horse understand me. How do you do it? I said. I have an understanding with a horse, he said. Yes, but what sort of an understanding? I said. A simple and honest one, he said. Well, I said, I wish I knew how to reach an understanding like that with a horse. You are still a small boy, he said. When you get to the 13, you will know how to do it. I went home and ate a hearty breakfast. That afternoon, my uncle Khushrob came to our house for coffee and cigarettes. He sat in the parlor sipping and smoking and remembering the old country. Then another visitor arrived, a farmer named John Byro, an Assyrian who, out of loneliness, had learned to speak American. My mother brought the lonely visitor coffee and tobacco, and he rolled a cigarette and sipped and smoked. And then, at last, slightly sad, he said, My white horse, which was stolen last month, is still gone. I cannot understand it. My uncle Khushrav became very irritated and shouted, "It's no harm. What is the loss of a horse? Haven't we all lost the homeland? Where is this crying over a horse?" "That may be all right for you, a city dweller, to say," John Byrow said. "But what of my surrey? What good is a surrey without a horse?" "Pay no attention to it," my uncle Khushrav wrote. "I walked 10 miles to get there," John Byrow said. "You have legs," my uncle Khushrav shouted. My left leg pains me," the farmer said. "Pay no attention to it," my uncle Khushrav wrote. "That horse cost me $60," the farmer said. "I split on money," my uncle Khushrav said. He got up and stalked out of the house, slamming the screen door. My mother explained. "He has a gentle heart," she said. "It is simply that he is homesick and such a large man." The farmer went away, and I ran over to my cousin Murad's house. He was sitting under a peach tree, trying to repair the hurt wing of a young robin which could not fly. He was talking to the bird. "What is it?" he said. "The farmer, John Byrow," I said. "He visited our house. He wants his horse. You have had it in a month. I want you to promise not to take it back until I learn to ride." "It will take you a year to learn to ride," my cousin Murad said. "We could keep the horse a year," I said. My cousin Murad leaped to his feet. "What?" he roared. "Are you inviting a member of the Gargoylean family to steal? The horse must go back to its true owner." "When?" I said. "In 6 months at least," he said. He threw the bird into the air. The bird tried hard, almost fell twice, but at last flew away high and stared straight. Early every morning for 2 weeks, my cousin Murad and I took the horse out of the barn of the deserted vineyard where we were hiding it and rode it. And every morning, the horse, when it was my turn to ride alone, leaped over grapevines and small trees and threw me and ran away. Nevertheless, I hoped in time to learn the ride the way my cousin Murad rode. One morning, on the way to Fitvejan's desert vineyard, we ran into the farmer, John Byrow, who was on his way to town. "Let me do the taking," my cousin Murad said. "I have a way with farmers." "Good morning, John Byrow," my cousin Murad said to the farmer. The farmer studied the horse eagerly. "Good morning, son of my friends," he said. "What is the name of your horse?" "My heart," my cousin Murad said to Amarnian. "A lovely name," John Byrow said, "for a lovely horse. I could swear it is the horse that was stolen from me many weeks ago. May I look into his mouth?" "Of course," Murad said. The farmer looked into the mouth of the horse, tooth for tooth. He said, "I would swear it is my horse if I didn't know your parents. The fame of your family for honesty is well known to me. Yet the horse is the twin of my horse. A suspicious man would believe his eyes instead of his heart. Good day, good my young friends." "Good day, young John Byrow," my cousin Murad said. Early the following morning, we took the horse to John Byrow's vineyard and put it in the barn. The dogs followed us around without making a sound. "The dogs," I whispered to my cousin Murad. "I thought they would bark." "They would at somebody else," he said. "I have a way with dogs." My cousin Murad put his arms around the horse, pressed his nose into the horse nose, patted it, and then we went away. That afternoon, John Byrow came to our house in his surrey and showed my mother the horse that had been stolen and returned. I do not know what to think, he said. The horse is stronger than ever. Better temper too. I thank God. My uncle Khushrab, who was in the parlor, became irritated and shouted, Quiet, man, quiet. Your horse has been returned. Pay no attention to it. If you like my video, please subscribe, like, comment, and share this video to your friends too. Thank you for watching and listening.